This is the BBC Home Service. Here is the news. No statement has been made about the Prime Minister's VE Day broadcast. No announcement has yet been made by Schaeff about the cessation of hostilities, but unconfirmed reports from correspondents say that the unconditional surrender of Germany to the Western Allies and Russia was signed in the early hours of this morning. They say the ceremony took place in the schoolhouse at Reims, which General Eisenhower uses for his headquarters. His chief of staff, General Bedell Smith, signed for it. General Suslaparov, who is in charge of Red Army repatriation for Russia. General François Sévé of France, and General Jodl, the Wehrmacht chief of staff for Germany. General Eisenhower was not present at the signing, but afterwards he received General Jodl and General Admiral von Friedeberg, who signed the surrender to 21st Army Group last Friday. General Eisenhower asked them if they fully understood the surrender terms imposed on Germany and if they would be carried out by Germany. The German delegates answered, yes, they did understand the surrender terms imposed and they would be carried out by Germany. General Jodl asked for permission to speak, and when it was given, he said, with this signature, the German people and armed forces are, for better or worse, delivered into the victor's hands. An hour or two before this report from General Eisenhower's headquarters, the German radio station at Flensburg on the Danish border broadcast a statement by the new German foreign minister, Count Schwerin von Krosigk. He said, the high command of the armed forces has today, at the order of Grand Admiral Dönitz, declared the unconditional surrender of all fighting German troops. The foreign minister went on to speak about the reasons for this decision and what it would mean, and said, Germany has succumbed to the overwhelming power of her enemies. To continue the war would only mean senseless bloodshed and futile disintegration.